नित्यानंदेश्वर समारंभां नित्यानंदेश्वरी मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां। I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis, srimahans, mahans, tanidars, kotaris, visitors, viewers, everyone sitting with us all over the world through Nityananda TV and Sadhana TV and two-way video conferencing. City is sitting with us in two-way video conferencing. Redmond, USA, Oklahoma, Somanatham, Columbus, Sri Lanka, London, Kashi, Hyderabad, Gupta Kashi, Seattle, Chidambaram, Toronto, Tirukkailayam, Houston, Kalahasti, Nityananda University, Paris, Scottsdale, Arizona, Singapore, Dubai, Vaidyanatham, St. Louis, Tirumala, Los Angeles, Hollywood, Atlanta, Georgia, Rajapalayam, Warrington, UK, Godalup, Rameshwaram, Singapore, Singapuram, Ohio, Prayag, Los Angeles, Arunachalam, Vancouver, Canada, Nityananda Nagara, Hyderabad, Dakota, Dunes, San Jose, Madurai, Los Angeles, Hollywood, Jorpati, Nepal, and some more cities, maybe San Antonio, Texas, and some more cities joining. I welcome all of you with my love and respects. Today, the sixth day of the Nityananda Brahmotsavam, today the Leela Alankara is realizing the incarnationhood, realizing the incarnation purpose, the mission. It happened in Omkareshwar. That's the Leela. And all the gods and goddesses are there today. We are going to be having Meenakshi Thirukkalyanam. The Devis, Mahadevas, marriage with Mahadevi. So, for Thirukkalyanotsava, everyone has gathered. Funny thing is that before even marriage, already the Subramanya has happened. Actually, Subramanya happened when Devi was Parvati. So, during the Meenakshi's incarnation, Subramanya already was there. So, we are going to reenact the Leela of Meenakshi Thirukkalyanam. Because of that, Subramanya will be there in the marriage. Only in the Parvati's marriage, Subramanya cannot be there. But in the Meenakshi's marriage, Subramanya will be there. Because Devi came down as Meenakshi much later the Parvati's incarnation. So, Subramanya also will be there. Today we'll be having the Meenakshi Thirukkalyanam ceremony and the milk abhishekam to Nityanandeshwara. You can all tune into Nityananda TV to enjoy Meenakshi's marriage ceremony, Meenakshi Thirukkalyanam. Let's receive the blessings of Mahadeva, offering aarti, then we'll enter into the satsang. I'll try to expand on the core message of Upanishads. Living Advaita. Understand, I am trying to set the context. I am trying to set the context. For you to internalize Upanishads. Nothing, as I said, nothing at all said extra in the Upanishads. As I said, you can't edit them. No editing is possible. It is so precise, perfect. And you can't comment on it. Nothing extra can be added to it. Maybe you can highlight something and go on repeating it. You can't comment on it. I was expanding yesterday on sacred knowledge, sacred understandings you need to excel, to reach your peak possibility in the life. I tell you, if you see a person sitting next to you, how you will feel? If you see a dog sitting next to you, how you will feel? If you see a plant sitting next to you, how you will feel? It is based on that, that is going to respond to you. Please understand, if you think the person who is sitting next to you is alive, you will react either love or withdrawal, whatever. You may react in a different one, some way. If you see the dog sitting next to you, you will react in some way. But if you don't react the same way to the plants, it means you don't feel they are alive. Listen to this logic. You will understand the conclusion. Why we feel the plant is not that much alive? The person is more alive, the dog is little less alive, and the plant is less alive. Why? Because we have a wrong knowledge. The action decides the life. No. Existence decides the life. Not action decides the life. Because a man can do more actions than dog, the dog can do more actions than plant. You gauge, you measure even the existence of life in them based on the actions. Please understand, this is the basic misunderstanding. Some of these basic misunderstandings can be repaired only by Upanishads. Only by Upanishads. Because only the Upanishadic masters carried that kind of an inner space. our architect who is doing this stage decoration for Upanishads, getting the plants, rock, everything. She suddenly comes and tells me, "Swamiji, really I have to tell you something." I said, "What?" "The plants kept next to you has grown taller, almost 1 feet." I said, "Come on, I heard enough stories." She says, "No, Swamiji, really, Swamiji, too tall. They are growing every day, day by day tall." I laughed and tried to brush it aside. She said, "No, Swamiji, I can prove to you. I can show you the height, day one, then day two, how they are growing so tall." I said, "They are also hearing Upanishads." First I told them, "First get me evidence, only then I will talk about it." Because I don't want people to make fun of me or fun of this whole idea of Upanishads. Listen, I do not treat them because of their action or inaction. I do not have an idea about them because of their action or inaction. Just like every day I'll bow down in front of Kalbhairava. See, the Garbhamandir door, we respect as the symbol of Kalbhairava. It is worshipped as a deity of Kalbhairava. So just like every day I bow down in front of Kalbhairava, when I come down, I always touch the plants in my garden. I touch all of them for a second, bless them and come. Because of their action or inaction, I do not gauge the level of life in them. Please understand. I have not done something special to them. I just did not judge their level of life. See, it's like if a dog is sitting next to you, if you judge it as a very low life, you may not even respond. That also won't respond. Even if you recognize his existence, he loves himself and loves you. Understand? Whoever makes you love yourself, you love that person. Whoever makes you love yourself, you love that person. It's law of life. Your attitude may be different, respectful, sometime reverence, sometime fear, sometime whatever. Whoever makes you love you, you will love that person. I tell you, my whole work is making people love them truly. I tell you, I am constantly respecting your existence as life. With these plants, the same thing. I just respected their existence. I never did anything else but before sitting in the seat every day I bow down to all of them. I do not have an idea they are somewhere lower. I just feel I am sitting with a group of people. If a group of people are sitting next to me, how I'll feel? That is exactly the way I am feeling. The way I respond to your existence, the same way I responded to their existence. For human beings, the way of responding to their existence is blessing them or healing them or asking their problems and giving some solution or consolation, courage. For these plants, just a good look. Look from the eyes which is respecting their life is enough for them to beautifully expand and celebrate, love their own existence. Love their own existence. Understand? And one good thing with the plants, you don't need to train them. They don't have SDHD. They don't have the exploiting mentality. They don't have the exploiting tendency. They do not have something which is not them as part of them. With human beings, they internalize something which is not them as part of them. So you will have to separate that and show them what they are. And I tell you, the moment I show what is you, you will just fall in love with you. The Mahadeva component of you, which fulfills whatever you want, which gives so much of feeling good about you, is real you. Please understand, all of you have the Mahadeva component of you. Which makes you feel so good about you. Sometimes people say, no, I think I never saw that part. I don't think I have that. I think when I came down, I left that in Kailasa and came down. Or after I came here, it got it parceled. Somebody stolen it. No. Nainan chindandi sastrani nainan dhagati pavakaha. No one can cut it and take it away from you. No one can burn it and take it away from you. All of us have the Mahadeva component in us. Which gives how much ever you deny, you do catch the glimpse of that. You do experience it. You can go on denying. No. That and all is not there. Unnecessarily, why should I imagine and create mess? No. You can go on denying. See, for example, if I deny the existence of these plants and did not revere them, respect them for their existence, nothing. They may not have grown. They would have just had their usual growth. But the moment I respect their existence, they also respect their existence. The moment I respect you as a sannyasi, enlightened being, the Mahadeva's embodiment, Shivagana, you also start respecting you. when you know the Mahadeva component in you is still active, alive, it has not expired, you fall in love with you. I tell you, falling in love with yourself is the only way to keep nityotsaha, nitya utsaha, eternal excitement. Nothing else can give you eternal excitement. Even if you fall in love with me, I'll push that love back on you, telling fall in love with your component of me, your component of Mahadeva. When you fall in love with me, you fall in love with my component of Mahadeva. Even that can be denied by your mind after some time with the mind game play and all that. But fall in love with your component of Mahadeva, which is eternal excitement, inspiration, nityotsaha, nitya utsaha. I tell you, the person who has touched the eternal excitement about himself, only he will have beyond logic tolerance. I tell you, illogical tolerance, the beyond logical tolerance will happen to you when you understand the Mahadeva component of you, the Mahadeva side of you, the God side of you. Because you will just be in love with that existence. You will just be in a trance with that existence. I'm telling you, being in love with that Mahadeva component of you is bhakti. That is bhakti. Whenever you go dry, catch that component part again. I'm really telling you, it will bring tremendous tolerance, which is beyond any logic. A man who has achieved the tolerance beyond any logic can never be disturbed or destroyed. Please understand, this is law of life. This is law of life. Because when you know the Mahadeva component of you, you are just in love with your existence. You are just in love with your possibilities. It is not some delusion. Please understand, it is not some delusion, it is not some illusion. It is not some delusion. It is not some illusion. It is possibility for every one of you. Some of these things no one can take it away, I tell you. No one can take away your consciousness. No one can take away your enlightenment. No one can take away your understanding. You are Mahadeva. Whenever tiredness, boredom comes to you, remember, I am Mahadeva and I have Mahadeva as my master to remind me and help me to reach the experience of Mahadeva. Don't immediately sulk saying, no, no. Yes, he will tell me to become Mahadeva, but getting up from the bed, moving the body and doing... He expects too much from me. He makes me do too many things. How can I think so much? How can I act so much? Understand, your inability to think or act never takes away your existence as Mahadeva. Your action does not, please listen, your action does not touch your Mahadevahood. You may be a Tanedar, not doing anything useful, just sitting, eating, dash, dash. Even that does not touch your Mahadevahood. Does not touch your Shivahood, does not touch your Godhood, does not touch your Mahadeva component of you. Understand? Somebody expresses it through their intellect, somebody expresses it through their body, somebody expresses it through creating complications. Now, there are some people who are doctorate in complications. They create so much complication before even taking two steps further inside, taka 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 taka, twisting, turning their legs, they have taken 2000 steps. I call them PhD in comp. Creating complications. See, creating complications. Why should I do? He doesn't love me. I think he expects too much from me. Unnecessarily, he is trying to think I am intelligent. Even if I am intelligent, why should I work? Why should I enrich the world? Why should I do this? Why should I do that? I think non-doing is the joy. That is one of the biggest lie you believe. Understand? Non-doing does not take away your Shivahood. For example, if you don't do anything, don't worry that your Shivahood will be taken away. No. But that is not going to make you experience your Shivahood and expand and radiate. If you are non-doing, you are doing complications. PhD in comp. when I request every one of you, you may be engineer in Noida or a doctor in Bangalore, lawyer in Ahmedabad, or a sannyasi sitting in Varanasi, whoever you may be, when I say you have Mahadeva component, I tell you the highest possibility of all knowing, all powerful, all ways blissful is your existence. That is your possibility. That is you. I am asking you to start living it, to start loving that component of you. I am saying, whether in your profession, in your career, in your family, in your relationships, in your life, express this. Decide how Mahadeva will respond to this situation. If Mahadeva is a lawyer like me in Allahabad High Court, how he will respond? Let me live like that. That is dharma. If Mahadeva is a doctor like me in Bangalore, how he will live? Let me live like that. That is dharma. Living with all your possibilities blissfully. That is all I am asking you. And immediately you start thinking, no, no, he is expecting, Swamiji is expecting too much out of me. That is why I am saying, PhD in comp, PhD in SDHT, self-doubt, self-hatred, self-denial. I am telling you. See, if Mahadeva component is not there in you, you can't even breathe. Why don't you understand that? The amount of things you need to do for breathing is 10,000 times less than what you need to do to finish all your projects successfully. All your projects, imagined, unimagined, are 10,000 times less than your breathing project. Good. Mahadeva made all that as automated. Otherwise, you will be sitting and drawing. Through the right nose, half an inch expansion hole and 2.5 feet pipe, if I inhale and then keep the air inside my lungs for these many seconds, by the time breathing is stopped. I tell you, how much of your consciousness, existence is required for your breathing? Only 1 of 10,000 effort and consciousness is required to finish off all your so-called projects in the life. Your life is far more easier if you exist. I tell you, everything is possible. I am not giving you any delusion. I am not giving you any illusion. People ask me, how your Gurukul kids are doing blindfold reading? Now, if you have eyes, you can do blindfold reading. Because you need to tie the eyes. Na? So for that, you need eyes. If you have eyes, you can do the blindfold reading because you need to close the eyes. For that you need eyes, that's all. I tell you, for all possibilities, you don't need a separate technique method to open them up in you. I am telling you, only whatever you believed is not possible for you, you need to undo those wrong beliefs. But there are tons of things you just did not bother to believe it is possible or not possible. For all those things, even just remembering, it will start opening up in you. Understand? See, for example, living without food. You might have started believing it is not possible for you, and actually it is not possible for you till you are trained. You need to go through a lot of yogic practices, meditations. Till then it is not possible. And ultimately it is not required. Just to have a glimpse of you, you can try sometimes those yogic practices. That's all. And it is not required you need to be completely without food. That is not required for enlightenment. Understand? It is just one of the yogic excitement. Listen. About this able to live without breathing, you know you can't because you started believing it. But there are some yogis in Himalayas. I have seen they bury the head in the under the sand and live something like 11 days. Okay. Whatever you already started believing not possible by you, you will not be able to do, that is okay. But there are many things you have not taken the decision. Our belief stand, it is not possible for you. Those things are possible for you. Going and talking to somebody and inspiring that person to certain idea which you believe as true. This you may not have believed it is not possible for you. If you start opening it up as a possibility, it may be available suddenly for you. There are so many things which you have not closed the door upon you are still available and open for you. Which you have not closed the door upon you are still available and open for you. Reminding you about all your possibilities is living Advaita. Reminding you about all your possibilities is living Advaita, and that can happen only by Upanishads. I'll continue on the Upanishads. With this, I bless you all. Let you all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching and causing eternal bliss, living Advaita, eternal bliss. Nityananda. Thank you. Be blissful.
Nityananda Dhyana Peetham, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Bidadi, Bengaluru. Phone 080-2727-9999. www.nityananda.org. www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.